Oh, okay. Awesome.
It's on. Green light should be on, right?
Test. Can you hear me? Okay. Praise God. What a joy. Where's sister?
I think she's right out here or something.
Well, don't let her leave too far. What a joy it is to be with you guys,
amen.
Everybody, and Pastor John and Karen. What great people they are. Hallelujah. And I want to say this publicly. One of these days, boys, I'm going to send her on a real nice vacation to the tropics. I'm just saying it by faith. I'm going to do it.
Yeah,
and Pastor John can go if he wants. I know Pastor Karen knows what she's like. And so I'm committed to that. It's great to see all the preachers. It's great to have all of our friends here and extended family here. This is a place that rocks. Amen.
Yeah.
I just love it here. And you know, the meetings are always good. And this year I'm filled up. I love Pastor Warren's message.
Yes.
Brother Larry, of course, is Larry, and it was awesome. Pastor Bob, I didn't get to come here this morning. We were up ministering somewhere, but I got to tell you, it's just been great, hasn't it?
Yes.
Amen. And then, so we're going to have this wonderful service tonight. God is going to do some great things.
Amen.
And then, it's Pismo time. So I'm excited about that. Amen. But, you know, one of the things that Pastor John said right when I first got here this week was we're going to have to use our faith to come into some things. And that stuck with me. It hit me right here in the heart because this is the time. Now is the time. Now is the season to come into some things, praise God. Greater things than ever before. And I know we always say that, and we should encourage in every meeting, we should encourage that. But I'm not just saying that because we want to be encouraging this year. I'm saying it because of the season that we're entering into. It is time for us to change our way of thinking, man, and come up a little higher tonight and begin to believe that God is God and that He can do, praise God, exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or think. Now listen to me, praise God, because we've seen it. We have chapter and verse. We have the book of Acts. We see what is possible with God.
Amen. 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 Yes.
And all things are possible to them that will believe.
Amen.
And it's time for this generation to begin to really believe big.
Yeah.
Can you agree with me on
that? Yeah.
I know you can, praise God. The Bible says all things are possible unto us who believe.
Amen.
Let me give you an example I'm talking about. Church as we know it, I believe, is over with.
Yeah.
Right.
That's right. It is. Yeah. True.
Come on.
True.
I said church as we have known it is going to be over with. And as far as I'm concerned, thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
I mean, it's been great. It's been wonderful. We have a great time. I have good services. And we have some awesome and anointed times. But I got to tell you, I'm waiting for God to do some things that literally will shock the world. Hallelujah. And I don't mean this presumptuously, but I believe it started. I believe we're in that now, and He's preparing us. And the last few years especially has been getting us ready to get to the place to where He can launch, praise God, an assault on the devil's kingdom, an assault, praise God, on the hearts and souls of this world, and reap that thing, hallelujah, and reap that thing until we get out of here. Hallelujah. I believe that. This generation and the next generation, the next few, if Jesus tarries, are going to be extraordinarily anointed and extraordinarily, praise God, they're going to have a love for God, and they're going to be free from the hindrances and the religious ideas of the past.
Yes.
Now, I'm not talking about weird stuff.
Right.
I'm talking about, we'll be on the word, but I'm talking about, praise God, let's look at what I'm talking about. Look at Luke chapter 6. Let me give you an example of what I'm talking about here. Think about this now. The same Jesus that did this back there is in the room today.
Amen. Yeah. Absolutely.
Luke chapter 6, verse 17 is. I mean, this gets me all turned on. And he came down with them and stood on a level place with a crowd of his disciples and a great multitude of people from all Judea and Jerusalem and from the sea coast of Tyre and Pisidia. Who came to hear him and to be healed of their diseases, as well as those who were tormented with unclean spirits. And they were healed. Now notice verse 19, because this is the interesting part. This is how it happened. And the whole multitude, all these people that came, sought to touch him, for power went out of the, from him and healed them all.
Amen.
Every one of them got it. In that service, when the power of God began to move like that, the people had the faith and began to reach out and touch the hem of his garment. Every single person was healed. Every single person was delivered. There was not one disappointed person in the whole bunch. That's something to shoot for. Everybody say, come on up, come on up.
Happened back then, it can happen today.
I said, if it happened back then, it can happen today. Every single person who came, no matter what their malady was, no matter how tormented they were, no matter how messed up they were, no matter how mentally ill and challenged they were, no matter what the sickness, disease, or crippling effects, or whatever it was, it didn't matter. Every single one of them got it and went away. Well, that can't happen today. Wait. Kenneth Hagin, 1950s, was preaching in a church one night, and he said he saw the glory begin to come into the church. And he said, he's up there. Now remember, see, this is kind of dating me, okay, because I'm from the 70s, 60s, and 70s, and I tell him, like my grandkids and my daughter says, that's the olden days.
Hallelujah.
Not that far long ago. Come on, man. Come on, man. But anyway, remember them days where they had the Polaroid cameras?
Yeah.
And if you ever have anybody, hey, how are you doing? Click, you know, on your face. And you walk around seeing that orange ball for like an hour and a half. You're half. Those things are dangerous. Half blind. Remember those?
Yeah.
I don't think Greg does.
I do.
Okay. But anyway, right? So Brother Hagin's standing up there like this. And he said it was like one of those bulbs went off, only extremely more intense. Just boom, like that, in the building. And he said, when that happened, every sinner that was in the building was transported from their seats up here.
Glory to God.
Every single one of them got saved. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Every single one of them got filled with the Holy Ghost. And every single person in the building was instantly healed or delivered.
Amen. Wow. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
I don't think you're excited enough about that. That actually happened.
Yeah.
In America.
Yeah.
And it wasn't really all that long ago.
Amen.
That happened twice in his ministry. Yeah. Two times that happened in his ministry. And I've always believed personally, what you think about the man is up to you, but I believe personally Brother Hagin was like a John the Baptist of this generation and this time of God. He had the best of the Word and the best of the Spirit. I always liked him.
Yeah.
But you see, if that can happen in Brother Hagin's ministry, why couldn't it happen today? But we're coming into these greater things, these awesome things. Hallelujah. But you gotta start thinking big, man.
Yeah.
You gotta stop thinking the church is the way it's always been. Oh, hallelujah.
Yeah.
Oh, oh. What a meeting we had. Come on, folks. Let's start thinking bigger.
Yeah.
Let's start thinking exceedingly abundantly.
Yeah.
Come on. Above all. Above all the great one asked for things. And I got a wild imagination.
Yeah.
I want to see God empty cancer wards.
Amen.
Yes. How about you?
Yes.
Just go down to the cancer ward, wherever it is in Madera or Fresno, and see God empty them. You know, when I see the pictures of those little children that got the cancer, that just breaks my heart.
Yes.
Wouldn't it be something if God began to visit to the church cancer wards?
Yes.
And children and people who had terminal cancers were instantly healed. And in this day and age, that would get around quick.
Yeah.
You could put it on Facebook Live. Live from the cancer ward today. Mike Purcell. And just walk around and pray for people and watch God heal them. Wouldn't that be something?
Yes.
Hallelujah. We can give Jesus Christ glory and honor. Because how many know Jesus is the only one who can do anything with you in your own strength? In your own abilities, you can do diddly squat.
Amen.
Amen.
Yep.
You know, I sit over here tonight going, Lord, please help me. If I don't have the anointing, man, I might as well just kick a can down the road. If the anointing of God don't come on me, I'm useless. I don't even want to be here. You know, sister, God, I'm sorry, singing the anointing.
Yeah.
I think sisters got the new. I used to have this girl named Tammy that was in my church, and she would sing. I could be in a Denny's restaurant somewhere, and she could be over there, and she could sing, and the anointing would come.
Yeah.
Remember? Pastor Bob remembers. She'd sing, "It's going to rain again." That was better than what I did. "It's going to rain again." You know, there's a storm cloud coming. I can feel it in the wind. Remember that? "It's gonna rain again." But better than that. Yeah. I sound like a cross between Bob Dylan and Willie Nelson. Little weasel. How many want to go up to another level? Come on.
Yes.
How many want God to elevate our thinking?
Yes.
Some preachers think too small.
Yes.
Amen.
Moving up.
We got to move up.
Yes.
We got to think up. I'm not leaving this planet until we have revival. Somebody said, "Hey, you know what? The Antichrist may be coming soon." I said, "He's going to come on the scene and take over." I said, "Not while I'm here. He's not coming."
That's right.
Right.
That's right.
Not while we're here. No way.
That
sucker will have the authority or the power.
That's
right. Until we can eat, man. He can't do nothing.
That's right.
She said, "Oh, I don't believe in the rapture anymore." Good for you. Aren't you something special? Take away everybody's blessed hope. Well, that's just escapism. You got that right. I want to escape one of these days. You know, if Jesus Christ comes back today, nobody will give a flying flip about this message or anything else. We'll just be with him. But until that happens, we got to start thinking. We got to occupy till he comes. That's what he told us to do. We got to be down here being salt and light. We got to get right in the devil's face. We got to take over every area, everything. We got to take over the judicial systems.
Yes.
We got to take over the political systems. And we got to pray. And we got to fast. And we got to get the devil out of the politics. And we got to get Christians in there. And we got a lot of work to do for me. So I don't believe Christians should be involved in politics. That's why we're all screwed up.
That's right.
Yeah.
You know, we're supposed to be out there. And we're supposed to make people really angry and not like us. On the other hand, people are going to love us because, you see, there's this love-hate relationship that happens with the body of Christ. In the book of Acts, you see it. One minute they want to kill him. The next minute, you know, they got great favor.
Yeah.
You ever see that? Because, you see, we got answers, folks.
Amen.
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 All right, let's go to another scripture. Are you ready for another scripture?
Yeah.
Simple tonight. We don't need some. I don't need these guys can teach. You know, Pastor Bob. I tell you what, when he gets up and starts preaching, all of us all preaching, I can tell you what, we're thinking I'm backslid or something's wrong. He quotes half the New Testament, I'm trying to look it up in the concordance. All I got to do is ask him, he goes, oh, that's whatever it is. You know what Pastor Bob's like? He, remember Jimi Hendrix?
Yes.
Okay. Well, when Jimi Hendrix came out, he's playing in England for the first time. And they had Eric Clapton was there, and Peter Townsend was there, and all the great guitar players of the day. And they all went, seeing that, they all wanted to go home and quit. He was so superior in his ability to play the guitar. They thought, I played my whole life, and this guy comes in here and does this. Well, that's how I felt when I met Pastor Paul. My God. I can't believe he quoted that many scriptures out of his mouth. He's like the Son of God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
He got great teaching.
Amen.
Tonight I'm here I'm here to exhort you a little bit and get you going a little bit and get your thinking bigger and get you beginning to think, hey, you know what? This could really begin to happen, man.
Yeah.
Acts chapter 1, verse 4. I love this scripture.
Yes.
And being assembled together with them, he commanded them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, which he said, you've heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days from now. Therefore, when they had come together to ask him, Lord, will you restore the kingdom of Israel? And he said to them, it's not for you to understand all that time stuff. He said this, verse 8, but you, this is what's important, you shall receive power when the Holy Ghost comes upon you, and you'll be witness unto me all over the world. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
And in Acts chapter 2, when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all of one accord in one place. Suddenly there came a sound from heaven as a rushing mighty wind filled the whole house where they were sitting. Now, Pastor Bob will quote this, but I got to read it. Where they were sitting. Then there appeared to them divided tongues as fire set upon each one of them. And they were all, everybody say they were all. They were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak the tongues as the Spirit gave them the utterance. Not one, not several here and there. Every single one. That's victory. That's what got the way God thinks. Everybody in the room got it.
Amen.
They went out happy.
Yes.
That's how God thinks.
Amen.
He wants every one of us to go out happy.
Yes.
That we receive what he wanted us to receive that night, that day,
Amen.
That service, that place, whatever it is.
Yep.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He wants us to be happy.
Yes.
He wants us to go down to church and come out of church different than when we went in.
Amen.
Every time.
Amen.
All the time for the rest of the time.
Amen.
Did you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
Amen. Now, I want to, since we're in Acts, flip over to Acts chapter 2. Look at some of this wild stuff. It's wild. Acts chapter 2. Oh, I got to read that. Verse 40. And with many other words, he testified and exhorted them, saying, be saved from this perverse generation. That's a good thing. Then those who gladly received his word were baptized. That day, 3,000 souls were added to them. Now, what they did, they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine, I should say, the word of God. And what? Fellowship.
Amen.
They actually got along with one another. They actually hung out after church during the week. Right? In breaking of bread and in prayers. What happened because of that? Great fear came upon every soul. And many signs, many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. And all of them who believed were together and had all things in common. They sold their possessions and goods and divided them along with all that had need. So that daily, with one accord in the temple, breaking bread and house to house, and ate the food with gladness and simplicity of heart, praising God and having favor with the people. And the Lord added daily to those that should be saved. Right?
Yeah.
Think about this for a second. Not one of them people lacked. How do you like to come into the place to where everybody in the body of Christ did not lack?
My mind.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, I'm going to say some things here that will not make me popular with some people, but you know what? I'm going to piss ball. I don't care. If you're in a certain time in your life and the government's helped take care of you right now, fantastic. But I believe there's a time where God's going to get people off these goals.
Amen.
And off of welfare.
Yes.
Come on. See, I told you when you go broke. Is that the side door there? That's the wall there. Okay, that way's the one to go. Okay. That is the door. Okay. Now, don't get mad at me and don't feel bad. I'm not saying you're bad for receiving help. Some people need and should receive help, and that's just the way it is. But wouldn't it be better, praise God, if you had a source for yourself and didn't have to rely on it? Come on. Yeah. Wouldn't that be better?
Yes.
You got to start thinking big, man.
Yes.
Well, that could never happen in today. Why couldn't it happen?
That's right.
I said, why couldn't it happen? Listen, we got a president, no matter what you think of that guy. He's a born-again brother in the Lord now. You've treated him properly.
That's yeah. Fine.
I know he's got some growing to do. Yeah. Sometimes, like, did he really say that? But he's a brother.
Yeah.
He's going to grow.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
And that guy, he's a multi-billionaire guy. People like that get saved. There can be some fun.
Amen.
Come on, everybody.
Yeah.
Some fun's coming into the kingdom of God.
Yeah.
For everybody can be helped. Everybody can be helped. Or whatever is necessary. Oh. Come on. Think big, man.
Yeah.
That was happening there.
Yeah. Come on.
Yeah. Everybody say, everybody got help. Amen. Then if you go over to Acts, I just got a few scriptures here. If you go over to Acts chapter 4, you guys get anything out of this?
Yes.
Or I hope that I wrote this one down right, because there's nothing but my pink thing. I didn't underline this in pink, so here we go. Acts chapter 4, verse 41. Nope, it's not there. Scratch that one off. I'm going to have a word of knowledge. Acts chapter 5 will do this one. I just got a few of these. Man, I tell you, when they start dropping, there's so much power, they start dropping dead in church. How many of that gets your attention? But you know, after these people drop dead in church in Acts chapter 5, I want you to listen to this. Because this really was happening. Through the hands of the apostles, many signs and wonders were done among the people. And they were all with one accord in Solomon's porch. Yet none of them rest there joined them, but the people esteemed them highly. Believers were increasingly added to the Lord, multitudes, both men and women. They knew what they were back then.
Come on. Amen.
Praise God.
You almost missed that. Okay. Verse 15. So they that brought the sick out into the streets. Now, folks, this is not a fairy tale. This happened. They brought the sick into the streets, laid them on the beds and the couches, that at least the anointing of Peter, the overshadowing of the Holy Ghost on Peter, passing by, might fall on some of them, and also a multitude gathered from the surrounding cities of Jerusalem, bringing sick people and those who were tormented with unclean spirits, and every one of them went away with what they came for. Now we got to start thinking big, because that happened.
Amen.
That's good.
Oh, it is so good, because God's scripture kind of gives us a goal for this generation.
Right. Yeah.
verses like that, that even the shadow, even the anointing of God that was on Peter was so strong, he just walked by. You know, you could be there by accident.
Yeah.
And just get it.
That's right.
Yeah. Just get it. If there was a demon, it'd have to go.
Amen.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
If there's a sickness, it is dissolved.
Yes.
If something was wrong, man, it was made right.
That's right.
If you had twisted knees or you had a bad arm or whatever, it just was made right. Heaven's atmosphere was so strong on the street. On the street.
Yeah.
On the street.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
You know what, man? We got to start thinking bigger.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on.
Sister, you got to start thinking bigger.
Come on.
You know, come here, sister. I want to tell you something. Don't you love sister?
Yeah.
This is Allison. It's not really sister, but we call her sister. We're one of my helpers. Now, if somebody gets up in my meeting, follow them up. I don't want anybody to crash and burn. You're supposed to get healed when you're in the meeting, not hurt. Now, you know, I'm as proud of her as I am my own children.
Hallelujah.
When I seen her up there doing the piano, I tell you what, that's worth coming to
show. Yes,
I thought, my God, look at these kids. They're so anointed. And she started playing the piano with such anointing.
Yeah.
But you see, she needs to come up another level. Even now, how old are you now? 13.
Wow.
I got to go over here for a minute. I can't take it. 13 years old, and already she's got a tremendous ministry and anointing on her.
Yes, amen.
Hallelujah. But you know, the Lord spoke to me. You know, there's an area of worship. How many love to worship?
Amen.
There's an area of worship we're coming into. Psalms.
Yeah.
Hymns.
Yes.
Like Sister Mary was doing. So I love that, man, because you see, that gets all over me. When people do that again, it's all over me.
Yeah.
Psalms and hymns and spiritual songs.
Yes.
Sitting at home, God's going to give her songs and hymns and spiritual songs. You know, she's got a whole wide range of gifts, far superior to what I got. I mean, I just get up there and eat all around. She can sing. She can play the piano. She can worship God. She can, you know, lead people in worship. Then she's going to be able to get up and preach.
Yes.
Then she's going to be able to teach. Yes. And people are going to fall all over the place just because she's in the room. Because you see, that anointing is stronger on this generation than it is our generation.
Oh.
I'm
good. Trained by God.
Amen.
And going to be able to operate just in a few years.
Yeah.
What we're all doing now. Think about
yes.
it.
Yes. Hallelujah.
And they're all over the place.
Bless them.
They're breathing.
Yes, they are.
You know those people out on the streets right now that are going, I'm getting paid to protest.
Mm-hmm.
Huh?
Yeah.
I've got a cause, baby. I don't know what it is, but I got one. Somebody comes up and it goes, now, I've got to ask you a question. Are you for the affordable air tax? The affordable care act? Or are you for Obamacare? And then but I suppose I've got to go with the Affordable Care Act because that's more affordable. Dear Jesus, help us. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
One more scripture, Acts chapter 8. Look at this. Uh-huh. You know, I wish Peter were, I wish somebody had that anointing on Peter, just kind of walk through that crowd.
Yeah.
Acts chapter 8, verse 4. This really happened. This really took place. Therefore, those who were scattered went everywhere preaching the word. Then Philip went down to the city of what? And preached Christ. Now listen, he's preaching Christ, Jesus. And the multitudes were of one accord, heeding the things spoken by Philip, hearing and seeing the miracles which he performed. What I say? Hearing and seeing the miracles which he did. I didn't do it on purpose. I don't think I did that on purpose. I didn't. For unclean spirits, crying with a loud voice, came out of many which were possessed. And many who were paralyzed and lame were healed. And there was great joy in the city. I mean, the guy standing up there preaching doesn't say anything about him having to, you know, go over there and calling his demons by name and all this. They just start coming out. They just start screaming. My name's Herbie. Well, the game's got weird names. I learned that a weird name, man. I had one the other day. What's your name? Come out, what's your name? I'm a Kelsenac, and I've been here for 5 years. Strange. They always got biblical. Obadiah. My name is Obadiah. I'm a deacon.
Amen.
Obadiah the deacon. But you see, we're coming into a time where we can kick the devils out of people in one Sunday in a whole city.
Come on.
Yeah. Brother Summerall talking about this. He said, the Lord showed me before I die. He said, I'm going to cast out 10,000 demons in one message, one sermon.
Lord.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
That was generous. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
I said, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, just those scriptures there give us something to think about, don't they?
Yeah, absolutely.
We got to start thinking big.
Yes.
I said, we got to start thinking big.
Amen. Smart. Amen.
I mean, I think we made our bed too short, our thinking's too short. We get in church, we expect only what we expect.
Come on.
We're not really expecting God to elevate the thing. Now, maybe you are, but for me, I needed a good jolt this week. Snap out of that. Snap out, Tom. Snap it. Snap out of the way you're thinking.
Right.
You know, you come down here, oh boy, we're going to get another meeting. You can get this way. Yeah. Another camping, another prophecy, another tongues and interpretation.
Come on.
You can get that way. You can stop.
Yes, you can.
Start losing
your
reverence for the things of God.
Yes.
Somebody said, you know, Pastor Tom, you know, I got to tell you, you know, all this stuff that you got charismatic people doing stuff, you know, I don't think it's necessary. We just need to, you know, have them come in and give them some coffee, maybe a little wine with their cheese, kind of sit them out there and everybody have a little Bible study, you know, roast some hot dogs, and, you know, sing Kumbaya, Lord. That's the way we do it. That's what we need to do to win the loss, because we have to become like them.
Right.
We've got to identify, you know, with them.
Right.
And we got to have our worship song with pink smoke coming out. Looks like the Doobie Brothers just came out and started playing. Oh, 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 oh Nothing wrong with that. I don't have any problem with that. But if it's a concert, it's a concert. Not worship service. I went to a church one time. First church I ever preached in Panama. We go down there, you know, I go in there, and I thought, man, this is in a ballroom, kind of a small gathering, about what like the people that are here today. Wasn't real large, you know. But they're all up there. They had David Wilkerson. Remember David Wilkerson?
Yes.
I mean, David Wilkerson make you feel like you're not sitting.
Yeah.
And he's up there, and they have him on the prayer. They're having a prayer meeting, and he's preaching the sermon through the hill there. And I just walked into this, you know, and I don't know, his sermon was called The Wicked Eye or something. Yeah. You know, it was heavy. Even though I'm getting convicted, man, I better repent. So they're going through this whole thing, and I'm going, wow, these people must be really like holiness people or something, you know? Something, I don't know, man, this is interesting. Well, I'll see, you know, I can handle anything. I've been around a long time. So they go through this, and then they get up, and they're going to start their worship service. So I'm thinking this is going to be really, really, you know, intense. And, you know, and all of a sudden, ding, the disco ball came on. I'm just going to try to the disco ball came on. And, you know, the disco's going like this. And they're starting to, you know, they're worshiping the disco ball. Still thought it was pretty cool. But, you know, I was kind of having a hard time. Then after they were in our worship, they always take communion. I mean, every time they take communion. We're going to take communion. We got guests today. They're coming up to the front. And when they take communion, they take communion. I mean, they had some big glasses. So big. This is the blood of the Lord. Wow! That's real wine! I mean, woo! Kate came with me. I think that God wants to expand their thinking.
Yes.
Did you know that Arthur and Kay are, Arthur's developing an app, kind of like Facebook? And I'm hoping that he's very successful and makes billions.
Amen.
Who's Kay? Kay's his mate. Arthur, I don't know, man. I don't know how you got this good looking on. You must have a tremendous ability on you. I'm teasing you. I do with all the guys, so sorry. How many believe that Arthur and Kate can come up to another level?
Yes.
They want to come up, right? Say, come up.
Come up.
Put your hands with her. Father, in the name of Jesus, let him come up, let him come up, let him come up. In Jesus' name. Let her come up to another level, Lord, in Jesus' name. Come on, everybody shout amen. About revelation from God on business and how to handle business. We're talking about people being saved because he's a giver. It's awesome to me to think about that. How many business people do we have here? How many business people? A couple of them. You got to be thinking big now. You got to start thinking. You got to stretch. Start believing that you can be more successful than you are now. If you got one sandwich shop, how about having 10 of them, right?
Yes, right.
Glory to God.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Right.
Thank you, sir. I was going to use that again, but that's okay. You ready to go to another level? Come on. Another level! Oh, where's my guy? Where's my guy? Whoa! Whoa! That was mad at that. Walking back and forth like this, minding my own business. And all of a sudden, I wasn't in my cave anymore. I was standing by those doors. That's interesting. I was standing by those doors. Now, I know this is a spiritual thing. Right? My body was back there, but my spirit was over here by those doors, and the doors were open. And I saw Mike and Monica, and I saw a big, ugly-looking, nasty, evil spirit standing right by them. And I knew, by knowledge from God, that this evil spirit was assigned to try to hold them back from ministry.
Yeah.
And financially. It's kind of all worse. And so I said to the, it's like a cartoon character of 50s. Yeah. Yeah, I said, well, I'm trying to explain it. It's hard to explain, man, you know. I said to that thing, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, take your dirty hands off my friend.
Amen.
When I said that, just that simple, in the name of Jesus Christ, of whom I serve, in Jesus' name, take your dirty hands off of their ministry. Two angels walked in the side, go right through the wall right there, walked right over and grabbed this thing by the legs and dragged it out right through.
Hallelujah.
The wall. Yeah. I thought, that's interesting. Then I was back. Fastest trip to California I ever took in my life. I wish I could do that anytime I wanted to. But then I said, well, you got to judge all things. See, we need to judge stuff. Don't be afraid to get something judged.
Yeah.
Right.
Sure.
Yeah.
Amen.
Do you agree with that?
Yeah.
I'm not afraid. If I miss it or I'm wrong, or I, you know, it's just like, you know, bad pizza or whatever. It's all right. I'm a human being. I might miss it. I might even say Sedalia when it's Bedelia. Doesn't mean I'm a terrible guy, a false prophet. It just means that maybe I missed it. So I wrote a letter to him about this experience that you guys judged this, and I sent it off to him. I did a letter. I didn't do it on the internet, did I?
No.
I think I actually sent a letter. They got the letter, and see, you know, their ministry really, from that time on, began to take off.
Amen.
How many know God is good?
Yes.
But you see, what the Lord was showing about you guys, is another level is there.
Yeah.
I mean another level.
Yes.
I mean another level.
Amen.
I see Pastor Mike and Monica doing a lot of work with younger people. I like younger people.
Amen.
And you need to give me a tithe off of the younger people. I'm not just kidding. I like younger people, but I see you guys doing things and reaching out to this millennial generation.
Yes, amen.
And even the church, having many of them here coming
yes,
in. Maybe
Jesus
conferences. You can have, you know, yes, guys like the great bearded one. You might even have me. I like kids. Amen. And I see, praise God, that. I see so much for them. How many know they're good people?
Yes.
Like Mike and Monica have grown a lot the last couple of years. So Father, we just release them into that higher anointing.
Yes.
In Jesus' name. Bring them to that place. The total place. Except for Dad. Dad, I would pray for I believe he's going to the next level. But he don't have to get up because he's earned the right to stay right there. Father, he's my friend.
Amen.
He's my friend. I love this man.
Amen.
He's awesome, isn't he?
Yeah.
You know what he told me the other day? He says, I'd like to sing. He said, not everything works as good as it does, but my voice is pretty good. So he goes over to the old folks' homes and stuff and sings for them. It's wonderful.
Yeah.
I'm going to live to 87. I'm going to live to 102. I said, that's pretty good. He's got some big things,
right?
Yeah. Father, I just thank you.
Thank you for blessing.
We bless him. Everybody say, next level.
Next level.
Oh, yeah. It doesn't matter how old you are. It does not matter how old you are.
It does not.
Do you believe in him? You want to go to the next level?
Amen.
What's your name? Come here.
Thank you, Lord.
Look at God.
Come on. Blessed
Jesus. Everybody say next level.
Next level.
You want to go to the next level?
Absolutely.
Spirit of America.
Amen.
Are you one of those guys that goes down to the mall in Madera and wears making America great?
Goes to the VA.
They go down. And wear Make America Great Donald Trump hats just to kick people off.
Hallelujah.
I think I'm going to have a Sanders Donald Trump hat on.
Amen. I go with you.
Make America Great Again. You guys ready to go to another level?
Yeah.
You look tired. You're tired? Am I boring? Okay. Senior in high school. And I had, one day to have straight hair, now I got curly hair.
Hallelujah.
Me, that's a beaut. Come over. So I go down there to school. Everybody's giving me a hard time about school. Hey, come over here with me there, buddy. Don't leave. So I go to school, you know, and everybody was giving me a bad time. About 2 days, then they all started getting it done. Hallelujah. I said, hallelujah. That's awesome. Yeah. How they In the name, it's a above every name. In the name of Jesus. We launch that. We launch that. We launch that.
Yes.
We launch that. I know they're young, but praise God. Let me tell you what the young ones are like. Lions are going to roar. They're going to roar. You are going to roar like a lion. You're going to worship and roar like a lion. The devil won't let you in. You're going to roar like a lion. Bold and strong. And not be intimidated.
That's right.
Amen.
Yeah, just watch out. Make sure you marry the right, you go with the right boys. Don't be messing around with the wrong boys. Hey, let me tell you something about that. If you would have met me in high school, I was the wrong boy. I was not the one you wanted to bring home to mom. You wait till years later when I got saved. You find someone who talks in tongues more than y'all.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes. Thank you,
God. I know you're not going to listen to me, probably, but I'm going to tell you anyway. That way, when I stand before the Lord, I made sure that I told him. What do you say here? Yeah. Come on. Another level. Whoa. Bounce.
Hallelujah.
Talk over with you. I want to see some whales this year.
Yeah.
My wife needs some good time at the beach. You know, when you live in Wisconsin, you thaw out. It takes you about a week. Come out here and thaw out. Then we go over to the beach. And when we go over to the beach, the Lord ministers to all of us.
Amen. Hallelujah.
We sit around, we talk, we tell war stories. And we have just a wonderful time of fellowship. I think it's really wonderful. I'm looking forward to it. Amen. So will you pray for us this week as we go?
Yes.
So I think God wants to do some things over there.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, of course. Open door for another level. Good man. Good man. Everybody say another level. Where's Pastor John? Unless there's other things that the Holy Ghost wants to do tonight, I think I've done what God wants me to do. Did you guys get anything out of it?
Yeah.
Did you guys get something out of it? Pastor Tom, you mentioned you're going to another level. And you know, as I was ministering last night, the Lord showed me something in the spirit. And, you know, the Apostle Paul said several times, he said, the Lord had opened unto me a door of utterance. And when that came out, I saw almost like an unveiling of utterance that you really are stepping into another level of a door of utterance. And man isn't not doing it, you're not doing it, I'm not doing it. The Lord is opening unto you a door of utterance.
Well, I receive
that.
And, you know, Pastor Thomas' message he preached tonight and then started really hitting on another level. You know, I just kept seeing the words, the word big and the word dreams. And the word big, though, was written big. Like, it was bigger than normal. It was bigger than the dreams, but it was big. And so I just really believe that we've entered into a season where God is wanting just to, he wants to start, what's the word I'm looking for? It's time to engage those dreams that you guys have had.
Don't give up on them.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and you know, and I'm talking about just the a lot of us have had supernatural dreams and visions over the past decades. I mean, a lot of the ministers in here have about your cities and your community, your families, you know, a lot of you in this, the place that have had these things. It's time to start rehearsing those again back in your mind. Asking God to bring those things back to you that he showed you. And start listening to him and start stepping out by faith into some of those things. Because it's time for a lot of those things to come to pass.
Amen.
Time to move in those, amen?
Amen.
Amen. So praise God. Dad, do you want to close this out? Amen. Amen. But no, seriously, big dreams, man.
The Bible says we have the mind of Christ.
Yes.
And I believe a lot of this, going to this next level, is you're going to have to be open to his thoughts. You know, he's given us that scripture a couple of years ago. Tom was quoting it again out of Ephesians 3, where he's going to do exceeding abundantly beyond all we can ask or think.
Amen.
And it's not that you're not going to be able to think what he's doing or him show you something, but it's got to come from him.
Yes.
You need to use that sanctified imagination he's given you.
Yes.
And just
amen.
Open yourself up and say, Lord, fill my mind with your thoughts.
Yes.
Because your thoughts are unlimited. Your thoughts are always absolutely correct.
Yes.
And he may say something to you. You know, when he put it in my mind that I was called to the ministry, that sounded like him telling me I was going to be Superman or something. That's about how far from my thinking that was.
Right.
And so he's wanting us to let him, you know, plant his thoughts and his dreams and his visions. It's time to start dreaming again.
Amen.
Not you just you coming up and cooking something up yourself, but opening yourself up and saying, Lord, put in my heart and my mind what your dream is.
Amen.
And what you have for me. And then as you begin to behold that, comprehend that, and step into it, by faith, you begin to appropriate it, you begin to agree with it, then you're going to start seeing it come to pass. You're going to go through that door and you're going to go to that level.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
Well, this has truly been a blessed time this weekend. I pray that you'll just take everything God's given you. You know, it's going to be on our YouTube channel. And so you need to look it back up, listen to some of the things that were said, maybe take some notes, write some things down, and pray into it. You know, spend time with the Lord around it so that he can just put this in you and take you to that place he has for you. Amen?
Yeah.
I want to thank everybody that came to minister to us here in Madera. Amen?
Yeah.
I know they blessed us. They blessed our church. Again, with all the volunteers and the ministry of helps that have just been so faithful to do everything. Well, Father, thank you. Lord, we give you glory. We give you praise tonight.
Yes, God.
We thank you. Lord, I know I'm just carrying you. I know you're always with me and in me, but there's just something that we're carrying away from here tonight that's on us. It's almost like a mantle that's upon us. And as we carry that into the prayer room and into the place of fellowship with you, and into that place, God, where you manifest yourself to us and through us, I thank you that we step up into that mount of transfiguration,
yeah.
That you lead us up to that place, Jesus, where we see you different than we've ever seen you. And we also see ourselves different than we've ever seen ourselves. We thank you for it. We praise you for it. In Jesus' name.